serving as a dog now.
Want a Marine?
Yeah.
No.
But whatever
is
your choice.
This morning.
If I do, he's going to have a storm on it.
That's all right. We're inside then. It doesn't matter.
Yeah, we don't care.
Leaving the cruise ship terminal. Here is our ship.
Rodney Fasnick. Okay. Yeah.
On our panoramic St. Lucia tour.
Testing 1, 2.
There's something on the net. This one can have
a backward. No, my MS at
the backward.
Okay, so first of all, I want to say good afternoon to everybody. That's not good enough.
Hi!
I don't think there are any folks on the bus. I didn't hear anybody say good afternoon. We're gonna go on cue after 1, 2, 3.
Good afternoon!
That's better. That's way better. All right, sounds like we are all ready for this, right?
Yes.
We're doing the last one for the day. Okay, so we have only 2 hours, 2 short hours.
That's all.
It's a good damn thing.
Yeah, so we gotta make it happen.
Yeah.
You're here?
Yes.
I'm here? Driver. He's learning how to drive on the wrong side of the road. Okay?
No, he's driving on the wrong
right side.
Oh, you're from the UK. Yes, that's where we got it from.
Thank you.
Okay, so my name is Ken.
Ken.
Ken. It's Kenwin, but Ken is easier to remember. Just Ken, no Bobby, just Ken.
Okay.
Okay. And the driver, his name is Marcus.
Marcus, yeah.
Hi, Marcus.
That's right. That's the driver with the PhD in driving. So you have nothing to worry about. Absolutely nothing. So it's everybody's first time to the island?
Oh, yes.
Great. Oh, someone said no?
2 years.
2 years? 1954. Oh, I wasn't born yet.
Wow.
Okay, so along the way, I'm going to be doing the commentary. But at any point, if you have any questions, please don't leave them inside. Leave all the questions right here. We only have 2 hours, remember. So, any questions, feel free to ask.
How many girlfriends do you have?
Oh, sheesh. That's a good question.
I ran out of fingers. Well, you want to know the ratio?
No, no, just have it. Okay. It's all right.
Is that a flowering tree or a bush?
That's a... It looks like one of those flowers they call Brazilian rose. The ones in the woods.
That's Brazilian liver. It looks like
that's the thing.
That's a, no, that's not Brazilian.
It's
a tree, yeah.
Is that an acacia?
Oh, God. No, that's not the Brazilian rose.
Still it
looks like the Brazilian rose looks similar.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Is the air conditioned good?
Oh yeah.
It's fine.
Could be a little cooler.
You can open up the vent. You okay?
Yeah.
Okay. You okay up front?
A little hot.
I was trying
to come out. It's going to be busy.
On the top.
The harbor is filled with cruise ships today, so it's going to be pretty hectic out there.
Oh.
Rush hour.
Oh. Oh, it's much better, thank you.
Yeah.
Oh, much better.
Okay, so, we're heading to the city center, the capital, Castries. Okay, now, the population of Castries is approximately 60,000 people. That would be the city center and the surrounding areas, or communities. And the name Castries is a French name. It was given to the place after a French minister by the name of Marquis de Castries. That was way back in 1785. But until 1967, this place officially became the city. You have the Castries Market, the local market over on the left. And you have the Vendors Arcade on the right. So That's where you get all the shirts like mine and all the craft.
Yes.
Okay, now the overall population of the island. Oh, no, I'm not going to tell you. Let's see who could guess, but I'm going to give you a hint. Okay, the hint is it's less than 200,000, but more than 150,000.
175.
You got to go up again.
185.
185 is very close.
86.
Extra close. Bingo. 187, that's right. 187,000 people living on the island. The total area of the island, the size, 238 square miles. So we usually say 27 miles long, 14 miles wide. Pretty small island.
Yeah.
If you look over on the right, you're going to see a statue right there. That's our first Prime Minister, Sir John Compton. He died in 2007, but when we became independent in 1979, he was our Prime Minister at the time. First Prime Minister.
How's the movie going?
Good. Really good.
Yes, that's the biggest church on the island. Right across there. Catholic Church. That's the dominant religion on the island, though. Close to 70% of the island is Catholic. The full capacity of this church, 2,000 people. It's a very big church. If you keep looking to the left, you're going to see a very big tree in the square over there. The name of the tree, the real name, is the Salmon Tree. But the locals did not know the name before, so they would call it the Massam tree. The word Massam is Creole for I don't know. Yes, so it's been there over 400 years, so it's a very old tree. Oh yeah. And you see the square, Derek Walcott Square? Who is Derek Walcott? He's a guy from the island. Well, he's passed away already. And he won a Nobel Prize for Literature. And actually, his brother won a Nobel Prize also for economics. So we have two from the island and the brothers. Yes, we're going to be passing up to the college. The community college is named after the other brother. Trees right here had to be rebuilt about four times. Why? Because of fires. The last fire was in 1948 and two-thirds of the city got burned down. And the question usually comes up, how did the fire start? Very simple. A tailor left his candle unattended because back then there was no electricity, and he went away to do something. When he got back, two-thirds of the city is gone. That building right across there with the Coca-Cola logo, it's a bottling company. So soft drinks, Coca-Cola, Sprite, water, is bottled right in there. Coming up on the left still is the Central Police Station. We're not stopping there. So, which island did you visit yesterday?
Barbados.
So, you east Atlantic side. Anybody in here loves like flowers and plants?
Yes.
Oh. Well, where are we stopping? The final stop, the highlight of the tour? You're gonna love it. Orchids and all different types of flowers. Oh yeah. House right up there, French colonial architecture. That's how the French would build their homes. And of course the English would use the bricks. Now most of the folks on the island have kept the English style, building their homes in the cinder blocks, with concrete. Yeah, so they have that style of it. Coming up is a photo stop, so we get to see the cruise ships in the port. So you can get your cameras ready. Yeah, it's cruise ship season, so every day pretty much.
Okay.
Until like late, you would say late March, April.
Okay.
Gonna get quiet.
Ah.
All the way October again. Yeah. If we were lucky and it wasn't so hazy on the horizon, we would see Martinique from here. 21 miles away from us, but it's too hazy up there.
We're the dinky boat.
Yeah, we are, aren't we?
Thank God.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh. Anybody noticed the tiny airstrip on the way in this morning?
Yes.
Yeah. That did the flights to the UK, Canada, US. Now to get to Martinique, which is just across there, it would take a ferry. It would take about like an hour. A flight would take about 20 minutes thereabout. And you also have the option of swimming.
For some.
If you look at the weather, you're going to see it's all rainy today, but actually we're in the dry season.
Oh.
Usually it is not that rainy around this time. Some things have changed. The rainy season, also called the hurricane season, is from June to November. And anything after that is the dry season. But even though it's the dry season, we still get the showers every now and then. That's how everything is all nice and green. And we usually get about close to 200 inches of rainfall for the year, so... Oh yeah. Things they could drive out here so far?
No. Great skill.
Oh, yeah. You get accidents, but not usually around here going down the steep sides. No. You will get accidents on the highways.
Uh-huh.
Not around. I'm going to show you my house.
Oh, okay.
You keep looking to the right, and you're going to see my house.
Wow, we were invited for summer.
There's plenty of space.
Uh-huh.
Oh, don't I wish.
Yes.
This is the residence of our Governor General. You got to press it down. The back of it. Right, so this is the residence of the Governor General. We now have a male Governor General, but before, That was until the last day of December. We had a female governor general. She was there for about like 20-something years. So she resigned and gave someone else a chance. Yes, and the governor general is actually like the ambassador for the island. And we're part of the British Commonwealth of Nations also. Yes, and he's usually appointed by the Queen or the British High Commission. So that's a very prestigious position right in there. Similar to the British, so every 5 years we have elections, and we have two main parties on the island: United Workers Party and the Sedition Labour Party. So right now, the United Workers Party is the one in power. And at the elections, we usually have 17 seats or 17 constituencies, which they no contest at the elections. Whoever wins the majority of the 17 is the one victorious. Say the community college. Show you our national tree. Anybody ever heard of the term calabash before? Some of the Caribbean islands also have it. See those round green trees on the tree? Yes. They're very heavy, mind you. Very heavy. No, it's like a shell or a gourd.
Yeah.
It's like we cut it in half. There's a mushy inside. We don't use that stuff. Get it cleaned nicely. Give it some sandpaper, nice and smooth. Get it dried in the sun. It turns brown. It doesn't stay green. And then you could use it as a bowl to eat. You could do some paintings on the outside. Oh. Make a musical instrument from the small ones like maracas. And you could do lots of stuff with it. It's actually like the French word. Yeah. Now the structures of the school look pretty old-fashioned. That is because these were once military barracks used by the French and the English during the days of the wars between the two. I'm going to tell you a little bit more about. So they refurbished them a bit and put the college right here. So this college has a lot of history behind it. Now the kids at the college right here, they wear uniforms. They would spend on average 2 years to get an associate's degree in whatever they're going to study, whether it be technical, business, science, you name it. Every department has a different color uniform. Football. Now that big tree over there on the left, you've seen it before. What's the name of it? I told you. The real name.
Oh, I don't know what to do.
the Masab Street. Right. Now these people right here, down here we call it the sleeping policeman. That's right. And in case you were going to ask if education is free, it is not. You got to pay for all your education from infant school all the way to college. Oh yeah, it's mandatory that every kid goes to school, but if you really cannot afford, you would go to the government to get some form of assistance. Same thing, yeah. Same as education. You got to pay for all of that. You would get some help, well, not all the time, but you would.
Yeah.
Some people would. This is the gravestone of Sir Arthur Lewis, the guy who won the Nobel Prize for Economics, and also whom the college is renamed after. Up on this side, you have a monument called Inniskillen Monument, which is erected to honor the battle, the 1796 battle, when the English took Montfortune, this area, from the French. The main college. There's
Okay.
Plenty of other high schools or secondary schools, primary schools or elementary schools here. Now some of the kids, when they graduate from this one, if they could afford, they would go to university. There is not a full-fledged university on the island when they leave that one right there, but there is an open campus, University of the West Indies, just down there. We can